what has 2020 been like for me? I'm sure if I say this, I'll be speaking for each and every one of us, that 2020 has been the most intense, uncertain, demanding year. There was COVID-19, we were just surviving the new year, and you know, we were just entering the new year, and then COVID hits, and then lockdown, and NSAS, protests, just so much going on. So 2020 for me was a year of self-discovery. You know, I got, especially the lockdown, people were complaining about it. I am introverted, so it worked perfectly for me. It was a time for me to look into myself and figure out what is my purpose, what really is it, you know, backtrack and see what I missed on my journey. And also it was a period for me to reconnect with God spiritually and, you know, just get back to the will and purpose of God for my life. And it's been the most amazing journey. I could never, I don't think there's anything I regret about 2020, frankly speaking. I'm sad about the debts, I'm sad about the uncertainties that happened, but personally 2020 was a beautiful year for me, based on investing in myself, self-discovery, actualization. It was a good year. 2021, I'm looking at a manifestation of everything that I've been able to invest in myself in 2020. And I deeply believe it's going to be a beautiful year. Career-wise, spiritually, relationship, every other. You can only be hopeful and pray to God. So 2021 is going to be a beautiful, fantastic year. God bless you all. Happy New Year!
What can I say about 2020? This has been a very unusual year, hasn't it? So much has happened that was unprecedented, unexpected. And for me personally, it was a great year, actually. But it was a time that I actually spent on learning and relearning a lot of things, changing my outlook on life, and really focusing my mind on what I want to achieve in the future. As I go into 2021, I look to that as a time of transformation for me, putting all the things that I learned in 2020 into practice for growth and for development. And really, as we go into the year, I pray that there's rejuvenation and people are refreshed after what we've experienced in 2020, and certainly praying that 2021 will be a much better year and that the world will be able to recover from 2020. This is me wishing you a happy new year and God's blessings.
Wow, 2020, it's been a once in a century kind of year, very interesting. But in all of this, I've been able to learn two things in particular, more about our mortality and intentionality. You know, we're all here for a finite amount of time, and so we must make impact, you know, we must impact humanity. And more importantly, 2020 taught me to take a pause and be more intentional about the things that truly matter. God, you know, my family, my career, my relationships, and my mental health. You know, it's easy to just go on and on in cycles and not take a pause, but we've been forced to do that this year. Going into 2021, wow, I just want to see some semblance of normalcy, to be able to just get up and go, you know, to see more social justice, the social injustice in the community. It was more real, more apparent with COVID and NSAS movement in Nigeria and all of that. So I just want to see a kinder community, you know, where we all care for the socially disadvantaged in the community. And more importantly, I want to see more growth, you know, on a personal level, to grow and, you know, for my career, my dreams and aspirations to begin to manifest, and for me to support, you know, my circle, you know, and essentially have a good year. Happy New Year to you and yours. God bless you.
2020 has been a year, but still I'm thankful, you know, for everything that God did and every little thing that I was able to achieve in my own little way. I'm so excited for what's to come in 2021, and you know, I honestly just can't wait. Very, very hopeful. You know, I pray that everything goes well. Happy New Year!
What a year 2020 has been. 2020 for me has been a lot of mixed emotions. There was time for laughter, there was time for joy, there was time for pain, hurt. There was a lot of things. It came with a lot of mixed feelings. There was time that I had so much hope, you know, that yes, maybe truly there would be a transformation, especially with the end SARS protest, you know, in Nigeria. And also there was a time of, you know, awakening, then the awareness that, you know what, you don't have to do things the way you normally would do things. I mean, especially with COVID-19 and the pandemic, it taught us how to do things differently. You know, people didn't have the chance to be able to go to work like they would. For me, I'm hopeful. I know it's the birth of new things. It's the birth of, you know what, transformation, like we've never seen it before. And I'm praying and I'm hoping that God gives us wisdom, guidance to be able to follow the times that we're at, because the times and seasons have changed. So how wise we are and how discerning we are to be able to follow follow 2021, you know, as we should. That's my prayer and my hope for everyone. I love you guys, and I know that this 2021 will birth great things for us all. Happy, happy New Year.
Wow. Now, if you're just tuning in, we're sharing hope for 2021. Let us hear what you have to say. Remember, you can join this conversation. Tweet at us at WeShowAfrica1 with the hashtag WeShow, or send us an SMS or WhatsApp to 081-803-84663. You know, we have a very huge team, 10 women. It's not easy. But I was really, really, you know, inspired by everyone, all the things that everyone said. And something really struck. I mean, I think we're very hopeful on ways.
Absolutely.
We're not the pessimistic kind of bunch.
We're,
you know,
optimistic.
We're very optimistic, and I'm so excited about that, because there is nothing that is more draining, right, for you to be surrounded with pessimistic people, people that are toxic. So even in sharing hope, right, for 2021, it is important that you guard your circle. Mm-hmm. Know the kind of people you're surrounded with, right? Mm-hmm. Know them clearly, and know that, is this person, after I have a conversation with this person, am I feeling drained, or am I feeling motivated and inspired to do something? Because that's why we're here. Waze is a platform to inspire people, right? Mm-hmm. We want to help provoke your thoughts and make you to take action, you know, even in the simplest ways, you know, without making it, not in a perfect condition, like our quote had said. Mm-hmm. Yeah, go ahead, Issy.
And there was also something that also resonated with me with what Sanzi said. She said that finding purpose and finding yourself in the process, be prayerful, be so prayerful. The first thing you have to understand is hope comes with being prayerful. If you're not prayerful, no hope. Like, you know, Jennifer said earlier on that, you know, she was a bit down. Then she now listened to the
message,
pastor,
yeah,
and her spirits were lifted. It is so important in times like this. 2021 should be a time to find your a reason for the season. If is the not church reason for the season, but reason why you are in existence.
Yeah.
Purpose. And it's also something that you have to find the wisdom to discern it. Like you said, it's a time for you to, you know,
yeah,
work
because
with
the
time,
the times and seasons are truly
in.
Have changed. Mm-hmm. Right? So for us, I think for me, what is big for me this year is the wisdom to be able to discern that, okay, this is what I'm supposed to do this time. And that does not come. So that thing, you have to connect to a higher source.
Exactly.
You have to connect to a higher source. You cannot just go into 2021 without a backing. There has to be a connection. So whatever it is that you are serving, serve that thing well. You know, we are hoping that you are serving the right God.
Right God.
Jennifer, come in.
Exactly. I like
and
that.
And speaking about hope, yes, it is great to have hope. I mean, hope is one thing that actually keeps us going. But in as much as you have hope, make sure you put in work.
The work, yes.
You have to put in work. You can't leave things to chance. And a lot of us left things to chance, including myself. Mm-hmm. I left a lot of things to chance, and I just felt like, you know, it's just going to happen. And then I kept saying something to myself. I think I was telling somebody, and I was like, that God got me. Like, no matter what, it will come true for me. Mm-hmm. And I wasn't putting in work. And then
you don't put in work.
Last night, my pastor actually now hammered on it. And then he said that if you don't put in work, or you don't actually pray to God and ask for what you want specifically, it won't happen. You're just leaving things to chance, and it doesn't work.
And you cannot live by chance anymore. Let's take in some of our audience. The comments.
Okay, I have this from Dede. He said, or she said, I am hopeful for new beginnings. Hashtag ways. And also another one. This one says, this is from Angela. Hi, Angela. She says, I am hopeful for what we call agape love. It's not agape, it's agape love. So I am hopeful.
Oh, it's agape?
It's agape, not agape.
We used to call it agape.
It's agape. So I'm hopeful for agape love and empathy. That's from Angela.
Wow. How about you, Jenny?
It's so amazing. At least in 2021, first day, you know that you have learned something.
Absolutely.
Yes, so agape.
Not agape.
But you see, if I go and be saying agape in church, they might not understand what
that is. Why I broke it down like this. As an elocutionist, it's what we call agape.
You're not getting the point. Pastors have preached the agape love. For years. So if I go to any church, maybe they call me to come and spread love. You know, what's it called? February 14th season. Spread love. And I say, no, let us practice agape love. They'll look at me and say, do you know what you're saying?
That's why everybody needs to know elocution. You know, they should be able to pronounce their words correctly.
Jennifer.
Okay, so Tokwe said, I am very hopeful for my personal growth. I want to improve my skills and unlearn negative behavior.
Fantastic.
You're on the right path, Tope. You're really fantastic. On the right path. You're really on the right path.
Now, another thing, let me buttress what she has said. When you dwell on negativity, it kills your creativity. So you need to understand this.
There's some preaching going on right here.
So you have to be sure that whatever is negative around you destroys your creative mindset. So you have to push it to one corner and dwell on the positives, because the positives will take you to greater creative value.
Absolutely. So if we had, you know, a good way of wrapping up the conversation tonight to say we want to give hope to anyone watching out there, where do we start from? You know, Jennifer, maybe let me start with you. Where do you think anyone should start from, for wherever they are, and the person is feeling like, you know what, there's nothing to live for, and I don't have anything, you know, COVID-19, blah, blah, blah. We have all those excuses, right? So where do we start from?
Okay, so first of all, you need to look inward and ask yourself a very honest question. Aside the bad things that have happened in my life, there has to be something positive, something that has happened. Might not have been you directly, might have been someone so close to you, someone you love. You need to look at their life and say, this is what I want for myself. There should be someone who you can use as an example. I am looking at this person's life and I want my life to be like this. And now after that, the next thing is, how do I get to this point? How do I move from point A to point B? So you need to be very, very, very intentional. Like I said earlier, do not leave things to chance. You have to be very intentional about yourself. You have to be intentional about your growth. You have to be intentional about your life. In fact, the words you speak from today, start speaking positivity into your life. I will be this. I will become this.
Affirmations.
You have to speak positive affirmations every morning when you wake up. Because it's, to be honest, it might seem like just mere words to you. Or maybe you've done it before in the past and it hasn't worked. Maybe because you've not added faith. Or maybe because you've not been convinced. You need to say with so much.
You're not even deliberate about it.
Yeah, you have to be so convinced. You say with so much conviction, today my light will shine. Today I will be favored. Or today I'm going to meet someone who is going to help
me. Today I will complete my task. Yeah.
Set tasks for yourself. Set little goals. They don't have to be so big. No, just little goals. Oh, today I'm going to read one chapter of this book. Mm. Or, oh, today I'm going to listen to this particular message. Or I'm going to watch something that is going to help me. Or maybe you have a course.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say you're employed and you have a course that you've been trying to complete for years and you haven't done it. Set a timetable.
Hmm.
Today, I'm going to watch 10 minutes of that video. Just do that and mark it down as a task that you have
completed.
Achieved. Yeah, absolutely. It is something that is progress, in my absolutely. Opinion. That is progress. You have achieved something for that day.
Absolutely.
So I think with that, you have a long way to go, but you are definitely going to be happy with your results.
Thank you, Jennifer. So how about you, Issy?
First, you ask yourself, what can I control? Or what can't I control? Because sometimes when the boys were kidnapped in Katsina, we couldn't control that. But you can control your destiny. How can you control your destiny? First, you are prayerful. Secondly, you are deliberate. You are intentional. I want to achieve A, B, and C this week, this month, this year. You break it down each day. It's so important because Pastor Sam said something. Prayers without works is totally
absolutely.
So you don't have to say it all the time. You can say, "Oh, I'm being deliberate." What is being deliberate? You take action for whatever idea you have. Don't ever downplay. Don't look at it like it's stupid. Because the man who actually created Spider-Man, he said that when he said it the first time, he said, "Well, why would I want to?" You know, talk about a guy who jumps like a spider. But today, Spider-Man is a household name.
He's a huge brown.
So please do that. Control your destiny.
Absolutely.
It's important. And don't forget to be prayerful.
Absolutely. So my word, I mean, I'm going to take a cue from what Temi Tope had said about impact. Be kinder to your community. Be kinder to, and just be there to care for people. So for us on Ways, it wasn't about just coming to start up a talk show. It was more focused on how can we change the narrative? How can we control certain things, right? We know that we have a huge gap in terms of ignorance. There is not much information as to how we can take ourselves from point A to point B, like Jennifer had said. So that's why for us on Ways is very important. We are deliberate about the kind of guests we bring, the kind of conversations we have, and the kind of conversations we drive, because we want to impact you, change your mindset and transform your life. Because if you are transformed, we are happy.
Exactly.
And of course, we'll have a better society. So for me, I want to say that there will be opportunities. For us on Ways, we want to also start something that would help unemployed people, right? Connect them with CEOs of companies so that they can help, you know, you can start up with internship. But when you are doing that internship with so much diligence, you know, you do it well. Of course, there is no employer that will see an intern that is so diligent and not keep you. Mm-hmm. So let us start from somewhere. We want to start that as our own CSR, you know, just a way of giving hope to all the people that are out there that have been looking, you know, for a way to find employment. That will be our CSR all through this year. I mean, for us, we are very intentional about how we want to impact young people. You know, we are extremely intentional about it. So even the kinds of conversation we are going to be driving on Ways, you are going to see that is a conversation that when you are done watching it, you will take deliberate actions towards your freedom, maybe financial freedom, emotional freedom, or whatever it is, that's your freedom. But that's our goal, and that is what we hope to drive in 2021. We want to make sure that nobody is left behind.
And it's so key. Shift.
I always say to people that a transformed mind has limitless. I mean, you do not have boundaries. Where you would get to is limitless.
Exactly.
Once your mind is transformed. So for us, we're very, very deliberate about mind transformation. And you know, the universe would always answer to principles. So that principle of discipline is very important.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about resources. It's about the discipline to follow through whatever it is that we have set out as our goals. So thank you so much, ladies.
And I want to add one more thing.
Quickly.
Learn to be more assertive and kinder to the people around you.
Absolutely. It's been a very, very insightful conversation. Ah, Now, keep all the conversation going on all our social media platforms at We Show Africa on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook as we continue to hear what you're saying. Now, look out for the video, because for what I've just said for unemployed youth, we're going to be posting videos on all our social media handles. So it's important that you follow us and you look out for those videos. Now, in case you missed today's quote, here it is again. Do not wait for the conditions to be perfect. Mm-hmm. To begin, do not wait for the conditions to be perfect to begin. Beginning makes the condition perfect. When you start it, that is when that condition will be perfect. We'll see you live on Monday as we bring another great conversation to your screen. Enjoy.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.